these niggas feel me. How the fuck they put me dead? Ain't nobody kidding. Four deep, 120 shots, it was real sweet. We was sending niggas tweets, it was real beef. In Chirac, you think I'm cheap, ain't no religion cheap. Get your ass left in the street, bad nigga, 5 feet. Young as they don't go to sleep, get caught like you try to eat. I know they'll kill me when they find me. If you really want, you can't slip up where your mind be. Niggas say they wanted me, they owe me, they behind me. Other way around, halfway down, niggas lied to me. Slime been an act of me, full COVID kept a mask on me.
Yeah, y'all, it's your boy Big Breezy in the cut, aka Big Breezy Gang. Welcome to my new subscribers. Shout out to the gang. You know, what's good with y'all? How y'all doing today, man? Well, tonight, you know what I'm saying? That right there was Young, it's off a Young and Ace album or mixtape, Life of Betrayal Times 2. That was featuring G Herbo. It's big. And if y'all, his album is pretty cool. It's pretty good. I like it. If you check out, if you check who's on it, you'll also see the late great King Von on it, right? Which this is what the topic is, right? I want y'all to vibe with your boy. You know what I'm saying? We gang, so we gonna take a quick thinker real quick. If Von, let's hypothetically say Von was still alive, y'all, right? How would this play out? Because Julio is cool with Memo and all of them. But Vaughn was cool with Youngin and Ace and G Herbo, obviously. So how would this play out? If y'all been following me, you know what I'm saying? I've been saying 600 is messy. And Memo's at the top of that. Because if Vaughn was alive, how do you explain that? How do you explain, you know, you fucking with people that he's cool with ops, which is causing friction? You know what I'm saying? And this is why I think Young and the Ace ain't want to mess with him from the beginning. But to be honest with y'all, you know what I'm saying? Let's get a little deeper. Now, I just start following on the ATK, KTA, aka ESPN now. That's it. They changed it. It's a six with a, I think the S is all where it's supposed to be at. They changed it to that. That's Julio's click, ESPN. Right? I just started following it not too long ago, a few months ago. You know what I'm saying? Because what caught my eye was Queso. You know what I'm saying? So I never knew that Young and Ace and Vaughn was clicking up like that, because, you know what I'm saying, I was still, you know, on the drill scene, because it was so much going on over there that, you know what I'm saying, you don't realize that when you don't see these people, they're clicking up, especially Vaughn. Vaughn clicked up with a lot of people before he passed. This is why Dirk is so able to go where he go, because Vaughn, you know, stepped over there. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, at first, you know what I'm saying, I was giving Asia Doll, you know what I'm saying, all the benefits a lot. You know what I'm saying? Recently found out that, you know what I'm saying, she might have did some foul stuff. So, you know what I'm saying? Her credibility to me is kind of shot. But let's just go with what we know, right? Now, she said before that, you know, Vaughn and Young and Ace was cool. Like, out of all the rappers that's not from Chicago, that's not O Block, you know what I'm saying, or 600 or OTF, that Youngin' Ace was a dude that he really called friend. I don't really believe that all the way. I honestly believe that him and YNW Melly was just as cool, because they was that cool that he clicked up with Tracks. So, you know what I'm saying? I think that Youngin' Ace was probably one of the closest people other than people from, you know what I'm saying, his hood or his town, whatever. So, only thing we can go by is, you know what I'm saying, we can't go by what Asia Doll said. We can only go by what we see. Now, Vaughn got a few songs with Youngin' Ace. So that would tell me that he was cool with the boy. He was cool with him. He was gang. He had to be. Vaughn don't just rock with anybody. So if Vaughn is cool with Youngin' Ace, you know what I'm saying? Regardless of him being here or not, you should respect that. Okay, he's cool with Youngin' Ace and all that. So we can't rock with Julio because that makes us look fool. But we're talking about memo600. You know what I'm saying? And he has, you know what I'm saying, a past that's not too credible. You know what I'm saying? Like, and maybe that's the reason why Youngin' Ace didn't mess with Memo, because let's keep it funky, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Like, the Florida people watch YouTube just like we watch YouTube. You know what I'm saying? They've been following the whole Chicago scene. And when, in the past, when you brought up Memo, it wasn't too good. You know what I'm saying? They dissed him. He had got caught lacking one time by Little Mister. There was allegedly his cousin robbed him. But the biggest thing that, to me, that stained him was the alleged situation with R.P. Scrap. That's the dude who allegedly, you know what I'm saying, we're going to say allegedly, killed his brother, Lil Steve, who now they name Steve Drive after. You know what I'm saying? Steve Drive. Before that, it was the Briggs 600. You know what I'm saying? Now it's Steve Drive due to the passing of little Steve, Memo's little brother. And there was a rumor that, you know what I'm saying, when Scrap killed him, whatever, they had the drop on Scrap, Memo and him. And allegedly they were scared. He was scared. He was passing the gun around. And by the time he passed the gun, Scrap left. You know what I'm saying? Then allegedly he got arrested, and then Face, Memo's stepbrother, told him. It just was looking all bad. Then the whole situation with C-Day and Rondo, allegedly Memo's sister was the one that told on them, but they placed it on Tay 600, which eventually he changed his name to Tay Capone. Like, you know what I'm saying? You see all that? You see what I'm talking about, y'all? Like, that whole situation right there, boom. That's Memo, boom. Then you got Memo doing funny stuff now. And all this, it's like, if Vaughn was alive, would you be doing all this? Would you be rocking with Julio and all that? Like, and then you getting Julio involved in y'all situation. Now he's, you know what I'm saying? He already dissed Mob. He already dissed Duck, of course. You know what I'm saying? And now he's going on Vlad, you know what I'm saying? Kind of like slick back talking on Youngboy. You know what I'm saying? It's cool to click up. That's cool. But look how you're doing it, though, bro. Like, you're being messy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know Youngin' Ace and Vaughn was cool. Why would you be clicking up with Julio? That's just messy to me, yo. Like, and this is probably why Youngin' Ace didn't fuck with you, because for one, he probably heard about your MO, probably heard about your past, and you know what I'm saying? I'm not putting words in nobody's mouth, but you know what I'm saying? Maybe people around Vaughn's camp, or you know what I'm saying, was telling him about Memo. Like, he's not really like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? And it shows, because you messy, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that shit was kind of bothering me for a minute, y'all. Like, damn, like, show your boy respect. Like, why would you be messing with his people's ops. Like, then if he was alive, it'd be a whole big situation. Then it started making me think when in that song Jump, was he really talking about you? You know what I'm saying? Like, if you ain't gonna shoot, just pass it, bro. Like, that was a line that, you know, Vaughn said. Like, was he really talking about you? Like what's your deal, bro? Like y'all let me know if I'm thinking too much, y'all, cause that bothers me that. Like, you really clicking up with, I'm not saying Julio's a bad dude, like, you know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, his situation in Florida, that's them, like, you know what I'm saying? But he's starting to evolve himself into the Chicago situation. Then he involved himself with that New Orleans situation. Now, granted, Julio had a run-in with NBA Youngboy prior to all this even happening. You know what I'm saying? But I don't think he'd have continued it by now, like, you know what I'm saying? But he got battery now, because he's messing with Memo on him, I'm really not trying to down Memo, but Memo's not the type of person that you roll with. Like, he's like that's the dude. Everybody, that's who you're gonna click up with. Like, Memo has issue with his own crew. So, what do you think is gonna happen with y'all? Like, if you do something wrong or do something he don't like, that you know what I'm saying? That Memo's just not the dude to click away, because he got a whole bunch of issues for himself, and I just think he's too messy. And I don't think, and I think if Vaughn was alive, Vaughn and Memo would have an issue right now. You know what I'm saying? And from what I be peeping, yo, these Chicago dudes don't forget ish, don't forget nothing, because I remember with the situation, right? When Memo got his chain took, Vaughn tweeted, "You get no more features from me until you get your chain back." You don't think Memo remember that? This is why he probably don't care who he click up with. If he click up with Julio, knowing that Young and the Ace and Vaughn was cool, because at the end of the day, he remember shit. Memo would look like the type of person to remember everything everybody said about him and all that shit. Like, he's that kid that, you know, used to pick on. Now he got a little money. So it's like, now I'm gonna be this arrogant dude. You know what I'm saying? Like, now I got the money to back it up. Cause you know that's what a lot of these dudes need. Money to back up whatever they are. Like, and I be trying to tell people, you know what I'm saying, and I'm gonna tell y'all, like, we give these artists, these stars, these actresses too much of a pedestal, because all they are is people with money. If they was a dork before the money, they're just a dork with money. If they was weird before money, they're just weird with money. They don't change. They don't change. It's rare, like, unless they're a stripper, you know what I'm saying, where you saw her flat-chested and booty all sagging to next year, she's titties the size of a D cups and the butt is cakey as anybody's butt that you ever seen. You know what I'm saying? That's just how, you know what I'm saying, people transform, but that they still remain that person. However she was when she was at, how she acting with before that, that's how she is now. She just, you know, she just bought stuff to improve herself. And Memo 600, he was sort of lame before the money, and now he's sort of lame with the money. So, like, I want y'all to remember that. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever they show us, that's what they are. Money just gonna help them show us more. You know what I'm saying? So we gotta stop, like, thinking like they know better to be. No, this is how they are. You know what I'm saying? Money don't change. Money just make them do it more and expose them. They expose themselves, because now look at me, like, cause, like, you know, I'm pretty sure if we had money, you know what I'm saying, with our, the way we think, you know what I'm saying, cause Breezy Gang, we, you know what I'm saying, we on point with ours, like, you know what I'm saying. So I'm pretty sure if me and y'all, we had some money, we would know how to, you know what I'm saying, correct ourselves and present ourselves when we around certain situations, and know that, you know what I'm saying, it's time for change. Now that you can elevate yourself, do it. But a lot of people don't do that. They just stay the same because they're not used to it. If you're not used to money, you're not going to change. You know what I'm saying? And it shows because they do such like petty stuff. Like, I think this is petty. This is low-key petty that nobody's paying attention to. Like, why is he clicking up with Julio if Vaughn was clicked up with Youngin and Ace? Like, come on, bro. That don't make no sense. And you wasn't talking to Julio or none of that when Vaughn was alive. I want y'all to pay attention, y'all. Like, 600 got a lot of petty people on they click, man. You got to give Booker some time. Booker already was showing who he was before the money, but Dirk is keeping him tame because, you know what I'm saying, and with the passing of Vaughn, it's more, you know what I'm saying, a lot of these dudes is hotheads, man. A lot of these dudes is weirdos. A lot of these dudes is temperamental. And a lot of these dudes, they're not just regular. Like, these Chicago people are not just regular people because they've been through a whole lot. Some of them just got OGs and people that's really keeping them calm. Because if it wasn't for them, they'd be wilding. Y'all don't believe me? Go back to before they got money. Read some of their Twitters, y'all. You can go back, it's on it. You can go back and you'll be like, wow, dude, talking like this, like, yeah. The same dude that they smiling now and all that, but they got a lot going on, man. So it don't surprise me that Memo's doing this, but I would think that he would like get the picture, like, yo, chill. Like, people are catching on that you're petty, bro. And you're moving wrong. You're moving definitely wrong. But tell me what y'all think in the comments, y'all. This your boy, Big Breezy in the cut. You know what I'm saying? On that late night tip, you know? We getting high and getting right. And we discussing shit. Like, tell me what y'all think, though. Like, subscribe in the comments. Talk. Speak to me. Holler at me. You know what I'm saying? And shout out to my new subscriber. This your boy, Big Breezy in the cut. Big Breezy gang. One.